Growing vegetables under protected cultivation is receiving utmost attention and gaining popularity among farming community across the country. These days, Government of India has been promoting the cultivation of the various vegetable crops under protected conditions. And under this program, large number of polyhouses in the states of Kerala, Himachal Pradesh, Karnataka, Maharashtra, Haryana, Gujarat, Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh have come up in a big way. The protected cultivation has shown promise in respect of higher crop productivity, both in terms of quality and quantity of the produce. The ideal conditions provided by protected cultivation and continuous availability of the host plant round the year often result in high population buildup of soil-borne pathogens, including plant parasitic nematodes. Indiscriminate use of agrochemicals in crop ecosystems has affected the beneficial microflora and has adversely altered the natural biological suppression which was hitherto been operating in Indian soils. The serious situation has led to emergence of nematode problems and nematode-induced disease complexes caused by several nematodes and pathogenic fungi and bacteria in various crops. There are numerous reports mentioning the difficulties faced by the farmers and nematodes, particularly in India. The root knot nematode has been a major pest of vegetables under protected cultivation. The yield losses to the extent of 25% to 27% have been recorded due to infestation of root knot nematodes in various vegetables. The population buildup is very rapid in the polyhouses and nematode population reaches 5 to 6 times of threshold levels within 18 to 24 months, making the polyhouses useless. Crops such as capsicum, tomato, okra, gherkin, muskmelon, watermelon, all these vegetable crops are being affected seriously by the nematodes in all the polyhouses grown across the country. These crops grown in all the states are seriously infected by root knot nematode and also reniform nematode. Nematode problems under this protected cultivation has assumed alarming proportion and the crop losses are to the tune of 80% in some cases when they are in association with the pathogenic fungi and bacteria. These disease complexes with the nematodes, what we call actually nematode-induced disease complex, are one of the major hurdles for productive cultivation of these particular crops under the protected cultivation. There is an urgent need for all the researchers to document and to generate the awareness of the nematode management strategies in India. Hence, in this particular program, we are trying to show the methods of the management of nematodes. It is what we call it as an integrated nematode management methods for the successful management of nematodes and the nematode-induced disease complexes under polyhouses and all these vegetable crops is being presented. The first step in the nematode management strategy is preparation of the beds. The farmers have to prepare the beds in a systematic manner because all these beds, when they have prepared, they will harbor a lot of nematodes. They would not really worry about the nematode populations. So the farmers have to check for the nematode population before preparation of the beds. The next step actually, they'll have to use certain chemicals like carbofuran or diazomet for the treatment of the beds initially. That will bring down the nematode populations tremendously. Further use of the chemicals cannot completely eradicate the nematode populations in the beds. Hence, we'll have to go about the planning a sustainable management methods. When we talk about sustainable management methods, it is appropriate to use the organic matter such as vermicompost, neem cake or farmyard manure. Farmyard manure, vermicompost and neem cake, 1 ton of this particular material and all these organic materials should be mixed with the 2 kg of Trichoderma viridae or Trichoderma harjianum and 2 kg of Pacillomyces elasinus. Pacillomyces elasinus is a bio nematicide and 2 kg of Pseudomonas fluorescens. Pseudomonas fluorescens is a bio bactericide. Trichoderma viridae or Trichoderma harjianum are the biofungicides. So all these three have to be mixed in the organic materials or in the FIM or in neem or in vermicompost we have to maintain a proper moisture. This enrichment has to be carried out under the shade. It has to be covered with the polythene mulch, and or it can be covered with the soil mulch. So the enrichment is an important process in which all these biopesticides and the bioagents develop innumerably. All these useful bioagents, the living organisms, tremendously multiply and make this particular organic material very useful for the management in the protected cultivation. 20 tons of farmyard manure enriched with the biopesticides have to be incorporated in 1 acre of land or 4,000 square meters of the land. It has to be incorporated thoroughly, and then the beds have to be prepared. After this, one has to apply vermicompost or neem cake, 1 ton of neem cake or 1 ton of vermicompost mixed with the biopesticides have to be applied in the beds. The neem cake enrichment, the process is very simple. Take 1 ton of neem cake, mix it with the 2 kg of Trichoderma viridae, Pseudomonas fluorescens, and 2 kg of Pacillomyces lacinus. Mix it thoroughly. Add sufficient amount of moisture. We call it as the optimum amount of moisture by maintaining 20 to 25% of moisture. Cover the neem cake with the polythene sheet or the leaf mulch for 15 days or 20 days. Every 5 days, this neem cake has to be mixed up for the proper multiplication of the biopesticide. All these microbes in the neem cake will multiply, and the neem cake almost becomes like a biopesticide. 10 kg of biopesticides mixed in the 1000 kg of neem cake is as good as 1000 kg of biopesticides. So 1 ton of neem cake enriched with the biopesticides has to be applied before planting the crop. After application of the neem cake enriched with the biopesticide, the soil in the beds has to be covered. Subsequently, one has to maintain the moisture in the beds. At least for 15 days, the moisture has to be maintained for the proper decomposition of these organic materials. Then the planting has to be taken place. This is the first and foremost important step. And once it is done successfully, that will help in the sustainable management of nematodes from the beginning of the crop. The next step, actually, these biopesticides, what we call actually bionematicide, Pacillomyces lacinus, and biobactericide, Pseudomonas fluorescens, and biofungicide, Trichoderma viridae or Trichoderma hargianum. These have to be mixed at the rate of 2 kg each in neem cake. For a period of 15 days, it has to be enriched. This neem cake can be applied to the beds at the rate of 50 grams per square meter at an interval of 15 days to 30 days after the planting. Regularly, if they apply, it will help in the successful management of the nematodes. This bioagent enriched neem cake can be used for preparation of suspension. The preparation of suspension method is: use 20 kg of neem cake enriched with all these biopesticides, mix it in 200 liters of water. And this particular neem cake suspension mixed with the biopesticides can be filtered and can be sent along with the drip, or can be drenched at the rate of 2 liters per square meter. This is the third step, actually. One can use this neem cake suspension mixed with the biopesticides after filtering for the drenching or for spraying. It increases the yield significantly. Because it is a plant growth promoter, it also induces a systemic resistance, and the diseases can be controlled, and the disease complex management will be highly successful and sustainable. In this particular way, farmer can use all these organic materials continuously over a period of time. This helps in getting a good crop. The Indian Institute of Horticultural Research has developed a product called Arka Plant Growth Promoter and Yield Enhancer. This is a combination formulation of Pseudomonas fluorescens and Trichoderma hargianum. This combination formulation is available as an organic biopesticide or organic formulation. This can be used at the rate of 5 grams in 1 liter or 5 ml in 1 liter, and it can be sprayed or it can be used for the drip irrigation. Once we start doing this regularly at every month, this will help in the boosting the crop and yield in a tremendous manner. And with the minimum nematode levels, actually, farmers can get a higher yield. The higher yield to the extent of 25 to 40% farmers have recorded.
Polyhouse alli ondu tomato, colored capsicum, hagu English cucumber. Ee mooru belegalanna belita idini. Iga ondu mooru naalku varshagalinda ನನಗೆ ಮಣ್ಣಲ್ಲಿ ಹಲವಾರು ಜೈವಿಕ ತೊಂದರೆಗಳಾಗ್ತಾ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಮುಖ್ಯವಾಗಿ ನಮಗೆ ಈ IHR ಕೆಲವು ಸೈಂಟಿಸ್ಟ್ಗಳ ಒಂದು ರೆಕಮೆಂಡೇಷನ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಈ ಟ್ರೈಕೋಡರ್ಮಾ, ಸೂಡೋಮನಾಸ್, ಫೆಸಿಲೋಮೈಸಿಸ್ ಅಂತ ಈ ಜೈವಿಕ ಗೊಬ್ಬರಗಳನ್ನ ನಾನು ಯಾವುದೇ ಬೆಳೆನ ಮಾಡಲಿ, ಪಾಲಿಹೌಸಲ್ಲಿ ಅಥವಾ ಓಪನ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡಲ್ಲಿ ಇದನ್ನು ಬೇವಿನಿಂಡಿ ಜೊತೆ ಬೆರೆಸಿ ಮಣ್ಣಿಗೆ ಹಾಕಿ ನನ್ನ ಭೂಮಿಗೆ ಹಾಕಿ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ಬೆಳೆನ ನಾನು ತಗೋತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಇದರಿಂದ ನನಗೆ ಭಾಳಷ್ಟು ಲಾಭದಾಯಕ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಹೇಗೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಭೂಮಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಕೆಲವು ಫಂಗಸ್ ಏನಿದೆ, ಯಾವುದು ಈ ಫೈಟೋಪ್ತರ ಅನ್ನೋದಾಗಲಿ ಅಥವಾ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಡಿಸೀಸ್ ಆಗಲಿ ಅಥವಾ ನೆಮೆಟೋಡ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ಆಗಲಿ, ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ಭಾಳಷ್ಟು ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗಿದೆ. ನನಗೆ ಮೊದಲು ಭಾಳ ಇತ್ತು ಈ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಮು. ಇತ್ತೀಚೆಗೆ ನಾನು 3-4 ವರ್ಷದಿಂದ ಉಪಯೋಗಿಸ್ತಾ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಈ ಜೈವಿಕ ಕೀಟನಾಶಕಗಳನ್ನ ನನಗೆ ಮಣ್ಣಿಂದ ಬರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ತೊಂದರೆಗಳು ಭಾಳಷ್ಟು ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗಿದೆ.
ಜಂತುಹುಳ ಒಂದೊಂದು ಗಿಡ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ 3-4 ತಿಂಗಳು ಹೋಗೋಷ್ಟು ತೋಟನೇ ಒಂದು ಗಿಡ ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಒಂದೊಂದು ಸಾಯಿ ಸತ್ತು ಎಲ್ಲ ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ. ಟ್ರೈಕೋಡರ್ಮ, ಸೋಡಾಮನಸ್ಸು, ಪ್ಯಾಸ್ಪರಾಸು, ಅದು ಮೂರೂ ಈ ಥರ ಹಿಂಗೆ ಗೊಬ್ಬರದಲ್ಲಿ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹಾಕಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಆ ಥರ ಸಾಯೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು. ಆಯ್ತಂತೇಳಿ 1 ವರ್ಷ 4 ಎಕರೆಗೂ ಗೊಬ್ಬರದಲ್ಲಿ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಹಾಕಿದ್ವಿ. ಮತ್ತು ನೋಡಿದ್ವಿ, 2 ತಿಂಗಳಾಯ್ತು, 3 ತಿಂಗಳಾಯ್ತು, ಒಂದು ಗಿಡನೂ ಸಾಯಲಿಲ್ಲ. ತುಂಬ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಫಸಲು ಬಂದಿದೆ. ಒಂದು ಗಿಡ 4 ಎಕರೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಗಿಡನೂ ಸತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ. ಗಿಡ ತುಂಬ ಹೆಲ್ತಿಯಾಗಿದೆ. ಈಗ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೀವಿ, ನಮ್ಮ ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರಿಗೆ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೀವಿ, ರೈತರಿಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ, ಸೋಡಾಮನಸ್, ಟ್ರೈಕೋಡರ್ಮಾ ಇದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ದಯವಿಟ್ಟು ಹಾಕ್ರಿ, ದಯವಿಟ್ಟು ಹಾಕ್ರಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ.
IHR ಅವರು ಹೇಳಿದಂತಹ ಒಂದು ಸಮಸ್ಯೆಗೆ ಪರಿಹಾರವನ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟರು. ಆ ಪರಿಹಾರವನ್ನು ನಾವು ಸರಿಯಾದ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬಳಸ್ಕೊಂಡ ಮೇಲೆ ಅದರ ಒಂದು ಸಮಸ್ಯೆ, ಜಂತುಹುಳಿನ ಸಮಸ್ಯೆ ಅನ್ನೋದು ನಿವಾರಣೆ ಆಯಿತು.
ಇವಾಗ ನಮಗೆ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಕ್ಯಾಪ್ಸಿಕಮಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೆ ಬೇಜಾನು ಜಂತುಹುಳ ಇದು ಇತ್ತು. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ MS ರಾವ್ ಸರ್, IHR ಸೈಂಟಿಸ್ಟ್ ಅವರು ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಅದು ಅಪ್ಪೈ ಮಾಡಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಇವಾಗ ನಮಗೆಲ್ಲ ಕ್ರಾಪು ಲಾಭದಾಯಕ ಆಗೈತೆ.
ಬೆಡ್ ಪ್ರಿಪ್ರೇಷನ್ಗೆ ಆ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ಗೊಬ್ಬರ ಹಾಗೂ ನಾನು ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೋ ಅದನ್ನು ಸಾಲ್ಗೆ ಹಾಕಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ರೋಗ ರುಜಿನಗಳು ಕಡಿಮೆ ಬಂದಿದೆ, ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಇಳುವರಿ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿದೆ, ನಮಗೆ ತುಂಬ ಲಾಭದಾಯಕವಾಗಿ ಬೆಳೆ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ.
ದಿಸ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡೈಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಚರಲ್ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಅವೈಲಬಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಒನ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಇಟ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ಸ್ ಅಕ್ರಾಸ್ ದ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ. ಮೆನಿ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ವೆಜಿಟಬಲ್ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ಸ್. ಹೆನ್ಸ್ ಫಾಲೋಯಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಎ ಲಾಟ್. ಮೋರ್ ದ್ಯಾನ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಎಲ್ಸ್, ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದ ಬಯೋಪೆಸ್ಟಿಸೈಡ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ವೇ ಇನ್ ದ ಪಾಲಿ ಹೌಸಸ್ helps the nation in a great way, because this will not lead to the soil pollution, water pollution or air pollution. It's a service to the nation if the farmers start using the biopesticides in a big way. These biopesticides, these technologies are being transferred by Indian Institute of Horticulture Research. Almost 300 industries have already got this technology, and many more industries will be able to utilize these technologies and produce the biopesticides and make it available to the farmers. All the farmers who are interested in this particular technology can contact director Indian Institute of Horticulture Research with a copy to Dr. M.S. Rao. And the phone number of Dr. M.S. Rao is 9480607571. Anybody is interested in purchasing this technology in terms of biopesticides for the registration and production in a big way in the country, they can contact the director with a copy to Dr. M.S. Rao. Thank you.